There was no sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use. The bulldozer's engine roared to life. Mud and rocks flew as it fought for traction.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alan. Alan. I'm so afraid. It keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. Something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
I'm so alone. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore.
So in the game, through these in-game television inserts, we learn about Alan Wake's writing process. How he was trapped in the study of Birtlek Gapin and how he wrote the manuscript. And we learn that he becomes aware of the Dark Presence's plan and how he starts to hide in keys for his success into the story. I mean, hiding his truth and his escape, his ultimate victory into the story. And there is an interesting metaphor there about writing process in general.
The darkness that was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path. As a teenager, just starting to get interested in writing, Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story, certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer.